registration of birth in Goa in Portugal invite loss of Indian citizenship. Okay. If you look at this, I don't get any other meaning. The meaning I get is the moment you register your birth, you get Portuguese citizenship. In Goa, at the time of liberation, that is in 19 December 1961, there may be a dispute over liberation or annexation. I am talking of 19 December 1961. On that day, we did not become Indian citizens. Let us be very clear about it. We became Indian citizens 1 month after the citizenship order was extended.
3 months.
3 months. Well, extended to, correct. After that citizenship order was extended to Goa. And this has been very clearly recorded in the judgment of Erasmo Siqueira. Because the question at that time whether you lose Indian citizenship. One of the challenges of Erasmo was that the India, that the country does not have right to decide upon whether he can take another citizenship or not. Of course, that question was never accepted by the judicial commissioner. It was not accepted by the Supreme Court also. See, in the case of Erasmo, I'll just take the case of Erasmo because I do not want to go into the case of the Benoni MLA because the matter is pending before the High Court. The matter has been argued over a long period. Somehow the judgment has not come. And whatever we may say, judges are very sensitive to discussion when the matter is pending before the court.
Not.
Anyway, that apart, I will take the Erasmo's case. See, Erasmo Siqueira's election was challenged on the basis that he has attained Portuguese citizenship. In fact, he had retained his Portuguese passport. He travelled on the Portuguese passport. He went to London and renewed his Portuguese passport. He comes back to India. He had given a declaration to the Portuguese government that he is coming to Portugal. Not only a declaration to the Portuguese government, he had given a declaration under Section 6, Section 7 of the Citizenship Order. And he got elected to the Lok Sabha. His election was challenged. There are three judgments in the year 1972 which are reported, and one judgment of the Supreme Court in 1974 which talk of this what is the choice on how Section 7 operates. How the citizenship order operates. Now the citizenship order gives you a choice either to retain your Portuguese nationality as on 20th December 1961 or you are deemed to be Indian citizen. You have no other option. And this, I will say, if you look at year 1972, page 11, it says to retain the citizenship or nationality which they had prior to 20-11-1961. Then again, another judgment, year 1972, AIR page 28, the first proviso goes to say that a declaration that a person making it chooses to retain the citizenship or nationality which he had immediately before 20-12-1961. So basically, what the Goa judgment said was that you have a right to retain or you are deemed to be Indian citizen. You don't have a choice. Now we will find there was another judgment which came up before the Supreme Court. It is of Reverend Monteiro. And I will tell you, it came up before a 5-judge bench of the Supreme Court. And Justice Hidayatullah opens the topic very clearly. Appellant is a resident of Goa. After annexation of Goa by India, he had the choice of becoming Indian national or retain Portuguese nationality. He had no other choice. The major argument before the judicial commissioner and before the Supreme Court was that the occupying country has no business to tell its residents to get out. and the Supreme Court says no. The Supreme Court also says, the five-judge bench, it's a constitution bench constituted, says that UN conventions will not apply to Goa, and hence the occupying country has no power. It would be the law of the land. And the law of the land is that you either choose to be a Portuguese citizen as on that day, or you get deemed Indian citizenship. Now there is a law, according to me, laid down by the Supreme Court. Until this law is changed, you may not be in a position to contend that we can still retain that citizenship and at the same time be citizens of India. The second part that I would like to say is, many times we talk about constitution, it is not constitutional law. All the provisions of the constitution from section 5 to 10 deal with citizenship at the time of the constitution coming into force. They don't deal with loss of citizenship thereafter. What applies to us is the Indian Citizenship Act. And under the Indian Citizenship Act, for us in Goa, it is the order. Now if that is so, let us look at how and why I say that registration of birth in Goa in Portugal invites loss of Indian citizenship. See, under Article 18 of the Civil Code in force, which we all use, defines Portuguese citizen as under: Portuguese citizens are those who were born in the kingdom from the father and Portuguese mother, or only of Portuguese mother being illegitimate children. Now this is Civil Code. Article 4 of Portuguese citizenship: all persons whom law or international convention consider to be Portuguese are such citizens. So a sweeping definition of Portuguese citizenship, that is a Portuguese whom law or international conventions accept. Now Portugal has amended their citizenship law from time to time, and the law in force currently is the 2006 nationality law. I will read Article 8, and I don't get any other meaning. And the only meaning I get from Article 8 is, you register your birth there, you get Portuguese citizenship. The second loss of Indian citizenship will see later. See, Article 8, the offspring of Portuguese mother or the Portuguese father born abroad who desire that a Portuguese nationality be attributed to them should express the will to be Portuguese in any of the following ways: declare that they wish to be Portuguese, inscribe the birth into Portuguese civil registration by making a declaration by themselves when they have the capacity, or through lawful representatives being without capacity. Now all they say is that you, the moment you inscribe your birth, you get Portuguese citizenship. Now Article 9, inscription of birth under conditions stipulated in subclause B of clause 1 above is done in Portuguese consular office in the central civil registry.
5 minutes.
If we look at this, what is it? If you look at this, I don't get any other meaning. The meaning I get is, the moment you register your birth, you get Portuguese citizenship. Now the second question, whether you lose Indian citizenship. This is another question. Now this will have to be decided under our law. Judge Brtitto said whether you have to decide this under their law, whether this has been decided under our law. Now the question is, our constitution is what we are following here. Under Article 11, Citizenship Act is enacted, and under Citizenship Act, we have rules of decision making. And in arriving at this decision, we have rules, that is Rule 30, which has stated, which has created a third schedule based on which how this is to be decided. Now how the Indian government decides, or rather the prescribed authority decides, the prescribed authority decision is based upon, first, the burden is on the citizen to show that he has not voluntarily taken, say, for in our case, Portuguese citizenship. So the burden is on the citizen to first decide, to first say that you are not a Portuguese citizen. The second is the most dangerous. Second is, the Indian government may make a reference to the embassy or to the Portuguese government to say, to ask them whether a particular person has taken citizenship of that country. Now, in our case, like the last case of the Benoni MLA, he said he is an Indian. They asked the Portuguese government. The Portuguese government said his birth is registered there. Under the registration of birth, he is our citizen. They further said that under Article 18 of the Civil Code, he is a Portuguese citizen. And that this declaration was not voluntary. The court held that he did not hold the passport voluntarily. Now, because under our law, that is under Section 9 of the Citizenship Act, if you hold a citizenship of another country, you can prove that I did not voluntarily have it. Now, Erasmus succeeded because he managed to prove that he did not voluntarily take it. Now, in the matter of Benoni MLA, he did not take the defense of he did not voluntarily take it. He said, I never went there. See, the difference lies, see, when it comes to proof, the matter lies there. That he said, I never went there, I never took. Now, if you have never taken, what has gone against him is the reference to the government, where the government said he is our citizen. And I will say that when it comes to citizenship, our rules are very clear that these are the things based on which they decide. The first thing is that they ask you to prove. Next is you have to prove that you are a citizen and you are not a citizen and the reference to the embassy. Now, one more thing I would like to say is that Portugal has shifted their citizenship principles from citizenship by blood, that is the type of principle that we have, to jus soli, citizenship by right of birth. Now, the point is whether we should continue with this system. To my mind, as long as our Citizenship Act remains unchanged, we may not be in a position to take benefits of dual nationality as various Western countries have. Now, one more thing I would like to point out. When some contend that we already have Portuguese nationality, India already permits us. We are different type of people because the citizenship order came to us later on.
Time?
2 minutes. One minute. See, in the year 2002, a L.M. Singhvi committee was appointed to go into this entire aspect because there was a huge demand from Punjabis, Gujaratis who are settled in Canada, Australia, US, England to have this dual citizenship. It was not because they wanted to come back here, but they also wanted to take part in the new economic reforms because India was opening up. They wanted to invest in India, and that is why they wanted to have dual citizenship. Now, L.M. Singhvi committee recommended dual citizenship, but in 2004, instead of giving a dual citizenship, our country gave this OCI and PIO cards very clearly, not in terms and in tune with citizenship. Because under citizenship, you have various other privileges which a non-citizen, a OCI or PIO card holder does not have. The point that I am trying to stress is that in 2002, there was this demand for a dual citizenship, for a person to say that I would like to come back and I would like to stay back, but this demand came from the diaspora and still our country did not accept it. So the question of saying that our country already has this position at law, according to me, is not possible. The courts have rejected this, and to that extent, I would say that if you register your birth in Portugal, you lose Indian citizenship, and that is the law. Thank you.